Welcome back to Microsoft Teams for IT. Today, I'll walk you through our approach to security and compliance in Teams, as well as the main considerations you have to think through to protect your users and corporate data. We know we need to strike the right balance between keeping your users productive and in their flow, while allowing you the visibility and control to protect your users and keep your organization's data safe and compliant. As part of Microsoft 365, Teams provides a platform for chat-based communication on top of a mature and secure foundation backed by SharePoint, OneDrive, and Exchange to deliver a hub for teams to work together with their calls, meetings, apps, and files in one place. As we covered in the first episode of this series, by design, you need to provision SharePoint Online, OneDrive, and Exchange to deploy Teams. When you set up a new team, a dedicated SharePoint site is automatically provisioned to store files and other content. And for every chat conversation, files are stored in the sender's OneDrive, while text and images are stored in Exchange. Leveraging SharePoint and OneDrive ensures that Teams inherits the rich security and compliance foundations of those services. This complements the controls that we give you to configure the core experiences in Teams with chats, meetings, calls, and apps for internal and external users. That said, enabling the right level of security and compliance for your organization is a shared responsibility. It combines the customer controls we give you to customize Teams with how Microsoft runs the Teams service. So let's talk about how we run the Teams service. When you adopt Teams, you are trusting your data to Microsoft. As you optimize for security and compliance, knowing where your data resides in the service is top of mind for you. Data in Teams resides in Microsoft's secure network of data centers in supported regions and countries around the world. Your data is kept in the regional data center or in-country data center available at the time that you provisioned your tenant. You can see which data center your data resides in by going to the Office 365 Admin Center and selecting Data Location on the organization profile. And of course, as Teams usage expands, we'll be adding more locations over time, and you can learn more about data center coverage at aka.ms/teams-locations. As you would expect, all data within Microsoft data centers is encrypted at rest and in transit. Also, we use the secure real-time protocol for audio, video, and desktop sharing. Files created, shared, or stored in a Teams team, including OneNote files, are stored in an encrypted SharePoint document library. And files shared and uploaded in a chat are stored in OneDrive, which is also encrypted at rest. Then, as your data flows within Teams, as a cloud operator, we make sure the Teams service is compliant. To help you answer questions from your auditors, we publish auditor reports for Microsoft 365 in the Service Trust Portal at aka.ms/stp. Of course, one of the advantages of Teams, like the rest of Microsoft 365, is that we help you keep up with evolving regulations and standards. Teams is built on top of Microsoft 365's robust compliance control framework and meets some of the most rigorous industry regulations today. We maintain around 1,000 compliance controls that are common to most regulatory requirements, and as new requirements emerge that may be specific to your country or industry, we have the agility to add new controls as needed. You can learn more about supported regulations at aka.ms/compliance offerings. In fact, the Microsoft Compliance Score allows you to see the service-level controls implemented and tested by Microsoft, as well as recommended Microsoft 365 customer controls that you can configure to improve your compliance posture. Speaking of which, let's now look at some of the controls available to you, starting with some of the ones specific to the chat, meetings, and calls. These controls can be organization-wide settings, such as allowing or disabling external access, or policies that you configure for specific users. To set these controls, think through the different needs of each group in your organization. For example, users in the research and development team may need stricter controls versus users in your marketing team. If needed, you can restrict the team's experience for guests and other people outside of your organization, such as external meeting participants. For example, you can disallow screen sharing in meetings or the ability to make private calls. Under meeting policies, at a team's level, you can stop external participants from giving or requesting control to a machine. To prevent unauthorized or early call access, you can prevent people that haven't been authenticated from starting a meeting. You can even go the extra step in meeting settings to determine if anonymous users can join a meeting. And if you use live events, you can specify the types of users allowed to join scheduled events from everyone down to specific users or groups. As part of your retention and compliance strategy, you can also determine who is able to edit and delete persistent chat messages. And of course, as we have covered previously, you can govern what apps your users have access to. These are just a few examples of security and compliance controls tailored to the core team's experience. To learn more, go to aka.ms/teamsecurityandcompliance. As mentioned, Teams is part of Microsoft 365, and at that level, we give you a wide number of controls to support a holistic approach for information protection across Microsoft 365 services. To get the right levels of protection, your users will play an important role, so you'll want to ensure that they take the right actions with their content. By design, protection policies can be configured to follow the content generated by your users. First, to help users make the right decision around who can view Teams content, we highlight if team members are guests or external users. Second, users can set appropriate read or write permissions as content is shared in chats. Content classification in Microsoft 365 is respected by Teams. Users can classify files by assigning labels related to the sensitivity of their content. These are tied to specific policies defined by IT, and we are working on broadening our capabilities to classify content within the Teams app. Then, using data loss prevention, you can also set granular policies that govern your data and define the specific actions to be taken when sensitive information is shared. Here, as a user creates a chat that contains sensitive information, they are warned of the possible risks through policy tips, their message is blocked, and further actions are triggered based on the policies that you have set. Then, as Teams is used on mobile devices, should the device be compromised, you can inform app or device level authentication using Microsoft Application Management, or MAM, in Microsoft 365. MAM allows you to selectively remove Teams corporate data, prevents the copying of corporate data into unmanaged apps, like non-corporate email, and can prevent saving files to local storage, and more. At the core of information protection is a robust identity-based security for access management and authentication powered by Azure Active Directory. This allows you to grant and revoke access to Teams users and protect against rogue admins by determining different admin role privileges. One of the most effective access controls that you can enable is multi-factor authentication, which requires users to use a second form of authentication to sign into Teams. You can take advantage of conditional access rules that govern access to corporate information based on the network location and device being used. To protect against attacks targeting your users or that could compromise your data, such as impersonation attacks or phishing, Teams is integrated with the advanced threat protection capabilities of Microsoft 365, such as Safe Links. This provides time-of-click verification of URLs. Even links shared in a chat are scanned for each click. Safe Links remain accessible, and malicious links are dynamically blocked. Equally, malware weaponized files can be detected in chats with safe attachments. And to take advantage of these capabilities, you need to enable them in the security and compliance portal. Okay, let's switch gears now and talk specifically about compliance. This is where you think through all potential audits you need to be prepared for and regulations that you need to comply with. From the Security and Compliance Center, you can see all the activities in Teams that are auditable. You can also set email alerts around specific activities, such as when a new team is created, or use this visibility to retire teams over time. As team usage progresses within your organization, it becomes more important for you to monitor and manage data. For your team files, we help you get a handle of your data. You can choose to either retain the data that you need for compliance purposes, or delete it after a specific period of time to manage your liability. Files in Teams retain the policies applied to SharePoint. By design, Teams chat is persistent and by default, content is retained forever. However, you can set retention policies independently for chats and channel conversations, allowing you to delete data within time periods as short as 1 day. Of course, sometimes you'll have the need to hold data and information to investigate internal incidents or for legal review. We allow you to search and analyze the information in Teams and to export Teams data from chat and channel messages. Rich filtering capabilities allow you to gather data across all users for further review. You can define conditions such as keywords, date, author, recipient, locations containing Teams data, or target research to certain users or specific domains. We also help you discover meetings that took place and the participants in each one. Teams is integrated with Microsoft Stream, so meeting transcripts from meeting recordings are also discoverable via search and eDiscovery. By placing content found in search on legal hold, you can ensure that data associated to a user or team is preserved immutably for potential use as evidence. This way, even if a user deletes or edits channel messages, immutable copies of that content are maintained and available in eDiscovery search. Beyond after-the-fact review of activities, there may be times where you want to be proactive by imposing specific policies around communications that promote compliance to your corporate standards or industry requirements. With information barriers, you can restrict content and communications being exchanged between a specific set of users due to conflicts of interest. To leverage this capability, consider who should know what information and what are the risks of different groups getting access to that information. For example, in the financial industry, there are specific concerns with how information flows in order to prevent insider trading. You can block certain user segments from communicating via chat or the sharing of files with each other in Teams. Lastly, if you need to comply or address a code of conduct in your organization, communication compliance, as part of Microsoft 365 Insider Risk Management, allows you, for example, to monitor your organization for communication violations in Teams, such as the use of offensive language. As an IT admin, you can set intelligent filters that use machine learning to detect inappropriate conduct. So that was an essentials overview on security and compliance for Microsoft Teams. Please check back soon to watch our hands-on demonstration on configuring Microsoft Teams to meet your security and compliance needs. You can follow our full playlist at aka.ms/Microsoft Teams for IT with upcoming topics such as Skype for Business to Teams migration and how to scale Teams with end user adoption. And if you are in a government cloud service such as the US Government Community Cloud or GCC, GCC High, or Department of Defense and don't see some of these capabilities available yet, rest assured we are working on it. And you can keep up to date at aka.ms/TeamsGovRoadmap. And of course, to continue learning more about Teams, check out aka.ms/successwithteams. Thank you for watching and see you next time.